In this segment, we're going to talk about, we're going to derive the multiple segment trapezoidal rule. So let me take the example. We had integral going from 0.1 to 1.3, 5x e to the power minus 2x dx. And if we're going to use one segment trapezoidal rule, I suppose, so I'm going to show you graphically what it will look like. So your 5x e to the power minus x is going to look like that as a function of x. And let's suppose if this number was 0.1, and this number is 1.3, then the single segment trapezoidal rule is just going to give you this much area here. Now, somebody might suggest that, hey, this creates a lot of true error, which is this part, which is not shaded here, that what we can do is maybe we can break this up into two segments. So maybe we can do something like this. So the halfway is 1.2, so 0.6, so 0.7 is halfway through. And what I can do is I can draw a trapezoid like this, and I can draw another line like this, and then what I'll have is I'll have a different area now under the trapezoids. So it is taking care of a lot more area. So I have this area taken care of by this first trapezoid, and this area here taken care of by this trapezoid. So you're finding out that by breaking it up into two segments, you are able to take care of more of the area which is under the curve, as opposed to just when you had only one. So this is what I get by one, and this is what I get by using two segments here. In fact, when I had one segment which was drawn, the value which I got was 0.53530. But when I have two segments, the area of this trapezoid here turns out to be 0.38175. The area of this trapezoid, the second trapezoid, turns out to be 0.40377. And the addition of the two gives you approximately 0.78550. So what you're finding out is that you are able to encompass a much larger area here as opposed to when you had only one segment here. In fact, as I said, the exact value which you're going to get for this integral here is 0.89387. That's the exact value of the integral obtained from the integral calculus class. And this is what we got from the one segment trapezoidal rule. That's by drawing a line from point A to point B here. But if I draw the line going from point A to halfway through B, and then again all the way up to B, I get two trapezoids now. I get two trapezoids now. The area of this trapezoid turns out to be this much. The area of this trapezoid is this much, and approximately turns out to be this quantity here. And you see that it is much more closer to the exact value as opposed to the one segment one. So we can continue to do this process. We can break this up into four trapezoids or three trapezoids or 10 trapezoids by just simply choosing different points going from point 1 to point 3 and be able to come up with a better and better answer or more accurate answer for any integral we like. But that's not what we want to do by simply drawing these umpteen number of trapezoids. We want to be able to develop a formula so that somebody can program it, or somebody can simply put the numbers into the formula and be able to get the multiple segment trapezoidal rule numbers. So let's go and see how we can derive the multiple segment trapezoidal rule. The only reason why I'm showing you this is to show you the motivation behind developing the multiple segment trapezoidal rule. So let's go ahead and do that. So what the derivation will involve is that let's suppose if you have this function, and what you're going to do is you want to integrate any function from point A to point B. You're going to break it up into n equal segments. So you're going to have B minus A, which is the width of the segment, and you're going to divide it by n, where n is the number of segments. So n is the number of segments. So that's what you're going to do. So once you have that, Once you have done that, that means that the distance between each of the segments will be h. So this will be a plus h, this will be a plus 2h, and the last point which you're going to see here will be a plus n minus 1 times h. Because the last point, of course, is b, which is a plus n times h. So that's how you'll be able to look at what those individual numbers are. Now what you're doing is that you're going to draw a trapezoid right here. Then you're going to take another one, draw a trapezoid there. Then you're going to take the last one, let's suppose. You're going to draw a trapezoid there. And there'll be several trapezoids which will be going from this a plus 2h to a plus n minus 1h, depending on what the value of n is. So all you're doing is the same thing as we did in the example. You are breaking up the interval going from a to b into n equal segments. And you're going to find out the area of this trapezoid, the first trapezoid, then the second trapezoid, then the third trapezoid, and the last trapezoid. And you're going to add them all up to be able to come up with the formula for the multiple segment trapezoidal rule. So you have the integral going from a to b, f of x dx, is going to be broken into n integrals. So that'll be exactly equal to going from a to a plus h, that'll be the first integral. So it's going from a to a plus h, that's the lower limit, that's the upper limit. Then the next one is going from a plus h to a plus 2h. And then you have the last one, which is going from a plus n minus 1h, because that's just h away from b to the left of b. F sub x dx. So keep in mind that going from here to here, there is no approximation involved. This is just calculus, that you are taking the integral going from a to b, and you're breaking it up into n equal intervals of integration. But there's no approximation involved in here. However, the approximation will be involved now when I approximate this integral by a single segment trapezoidal rule, this particular integral by a single segment trapezoidal rule, and this last one also by the single segment trapezoidal rule, and all the ones which are in between there. So that's where the approximation will come from. So let's look at what that approximation will be. It will be equal to the width of the interval, which is simply h, because you're going from a to a plus h, so the width of the interval is just h, times the value of the function at a plus the value of the function at a plus h, because those are the limits of the integral there. And this next one also, the width of the interval will be h, because you're going from a plus h to a plus 2h. So you'll get f of a plus h plus f of a plus 2h divided by 2, plus all the way up to h times the value of the function at a plus n minus 1h plus f of b divided by 2. That's what you're going to get for these individual integrals that you have. Keep in mind that there are several integrals that you have to calculate here. I'm not showing all of them, but that's what you'll have to do. So you can very well see that h divided by 2 is a common number here. h2 is a common multiple here. We're going to take that out. And then you have to recognize that f of a is only here once. F of a is only here once. However, f of a plus h is once here and once here. So that becomes 2 f of a plus h. And then f of a plus 2h will be once here and once in the next term, which I have not shown here. But that will be also 2 times f of a plus 2h. And then we'll go all the way up to f of b. So you can very well see that you have these terms. Let me just go ahead and show you some more terms. Let me just erase this here. And we'll have plus going up to plus 2 times f of a plus n minus 1 times h. Because this term, which is at this argument, we'll also have a term in the term before. There'll be the same, exactly the same argument of the function will be in the term right before this one. So that'll be also twice, but f sub b will be only once because it's the last integral there. So what you're seeing here is that this h is b minus a divided by 2n, because h is b minus a divided by n, because h is the width of each segment, which will be b minus a divided by n. The 2 is coming from here. Then you have f sub a plus 2, I'm going to put outside, but there'll be a summation. I is equal to 1 to n minus 1, f sub a plus I h. And the reason why you're getting a summation here, because it's a plus h, a plus 2h, all the way up to a plus n minus 1h. So the only thing which is changing is the argument of a, the coefficient of h is 1 here, 2 here, n minus 1 here. So that's why we contract it into a summation, I going from 1 to n minus 1, f sub a plus ih, plus f sub b. And that is the formula for the multiple segment trapezoidal rule. So again, what you're going to find out is that it is very similar to what happened previously in terms of the averages, that this is the width of the interval, and this number here, or this expression here, is some average value of the function. And then somebody might say, hey, I got f sub a here, but you got two times the function evaluations at n minus 1 points. You got n minus 1 function evaluations taking place, but they are represented twice. So that means that one time here, two times n minus 1 times here, and one time there, and that makes it 2n. So these function summations which are being done are being done 2n times, and then you are dividing the function summation by 2n, which gives you some average value of the function, and then you are multiplying it by the width of the interval. And that's the end of this segment.